Hello everyone, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Well, we are on the way to see how to run Empire Rising Civilizations on your PC. Now you are able to watch it on your screen. It takes almost no time to efficiently download and set up Empire Rising Civilizations and enjoy playing your game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type anything, simply because there's the clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We landed right here on our website of Usitility, in which we get in-depth information on how to obtain Empire Rising Civilizations on personal computer. We scroll down a bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we will run to play Empire Rising Civilizations on PC. As you can see from here, we get several pros of preferring this emulator. Now we will proceed to download the Empire Rising Civilizations by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. The step is clicking on it, and the download action starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to launch the installer, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the computer. We answered yes. I minimize the browser to see the installer better. The installer is uncomplicated. It consists of two choices, install, and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path truly does. We merely click it, so we observe that we have here the path in which the emulator is going to be set up. If we need to vary this directory, we need to click on this browse button, so we opt for another folder and set up the emulator exactly where we choose. I prefer to leave it by default. I simply click on back. And I simply click on install. Now, there it is. The installation starts and it's going to carry on together with the download of those MB that are shown on this screen. The moment you save it on your machine, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate will go faster or slower, based on your web access and depending on the performance of the emulator web servers. Right away they're working super fast. The download is done, and now it continues with the setup step. The installation is going to take more or less time according to the strength of your computer or laptop. The more efficient it's actually, the faster the software installation time and vice versa. If we integrate the download and software installation phase, it may take quite a while, so have patience. It has by now ended for me. Now, the emulator has been launched immediately. As you can see, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up so when it actually reaches the finish, the emulator will be launched for the very first time. In reality, the emulator has already been launched, here for the first time. Before we continue, as you can discover, it has created two software icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the one we're focused on. At any time when we need to launch Empire Rising Civilizations on the PC, we twice mouse click on this particular icon and as a result start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon is not about multiplayer or even anything like this. The reality is, it is an app icon that we might very likely never ever start using. Let's do the next step. That is a requirement, and that's to begin browsing the Google Play Store. As you can discover, the Google Play is launched. Here we must log on. At this moment when we are there, we have to accomplish the following step which is obligatory. So that we simply click on, sign in. Now it says, checking info. It can in some cases get blocked in, checking info, and this doesn't advance. If so, you can try to log in after a couple of hours and it'll most certainly be solved. Now we will enter our email and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email address and its related password. For instance, you could use the same exact email you're using at the moment in your YouTube account. So that I will insert my data and I will return when I have completed it. That's it, data entered. And here is Google welcoming us and supplying us the terms of service. We should agree to all of them by simply hitting, I agree. Next, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You could let it checked and it'll build a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can use that option if you desire. We simply click on accept. Google Play is launched by default and immediately. To set up the app game, we must browse the emulator desktop by left-clicking that icon indicated green-colored. Now that we are on the desktop of the Android emulator, we notice that we now have right here the install application button. We mouse-click on that button. Here we get the game. Let's quickly simply click there on the install option that I am just highlighting now in green. And it will begin the installation. At present it would install the game app, it might take some time or perhaps it might possibly be amazingly quickly. It again all is dependent upon on the web connection. This has just finished installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting this button that I'm presenting in green, to be able to start Empire Rising Civilizations for the first time. Let's mouse click on the My Games option proceeding. We are by now on the emulator desktop, and we are preparing to just click on that brand new Empire Rising Civilizations icon that's been generated. The game is launched for the very first time. Now there we have it, I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will comment on the volume of this emulator. It's here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume, this way we won't count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we could switch on the big screen, for which we have two choices. This is the first one, we mouse click on this particular icon that I'm mentioning in green. And the screen is maximized, having one border on top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. In case we desire to enjoy the video game using all the screen, we click on this particular game icon. And we'd already be experiencing the game app in full screen setting. To quit the full screen setting, click the F11 key. And we might already end up being in regular computer screen mode. Now I am starting to show you the computer keyboard mapping that is actually extremely enjoyable. This means we will likely be capable to operate the game application a lot more effortlessly. The first task is to mouse click this computer keyboard icon. And there you will be able to make the required configuration settings. I am about to keep the standard configuration, however if you need to modify this, you may very well do so with no problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is totally in our language. In some cases it occurs that the emulator is started in the improper language, for example, in Chinese language. And consequently to set it in the right language we browse here to the cogwheel. And here within additional options, we simply click on the language drop down. We may select the language we like, Spanish, Japanese, and so on. As soon as the language is determined, we could save, the emulator will restart, as well as the Android game, the next time we launch it, would as well be in the opted for language. At this moment, there is another detail that we will need to take into consideration, and it is that we will receive an email indicating that a brand new equipment has been linked to this Google account. It will definitely check with us if we're the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Indeed, we shouldn't get worried, as the emulator is simulating an Android electronic device. And to discover which device is being emulated, we go here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Therefore we go here to the model option. And right here we determine that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for the training. I anticipate you liked it, particularly that everyone found it helpful. In this case, offer it a superb thumb up, subscribe, and any comments, requests or ideas, leave them in the comment box below. You also can leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every now and then, you have it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of the online videos which are usually showing up on the computer screen and see you in the next training videos. Bye.